Cut six, best of the little man.
Couple of our favorite little man bits, including two of my personal choices. The poem on Dickert's 39th birthday, which is coming at the end, which was like so incredibly funny to me because only I knew that Duke was in the middle of renegotiating his contract at the time. And we'll get to that plus his famous snowbird thing right after a word from our sponsor.
I tried to cook a turkey last year for Thanksgiving. After 22 hours in the oven, there wasn't nothing left but a shrunken drumstick and a melted plastic bag full of innards.
Well, this year you can get the bird without any shrinkage, because Ian and the KDF Morning Boners are offering for the first time in the Nashville market the Turkey Crotch Pot. Using a special heating pad and copper-lined boxer shorts, you can now go about your business while cooking a turkey down there, right inside your pants.
I got that crotch pot, stuck a big butter ball down in my pants, put it on 475, and went about my business.
You'll be wanting to cook a lot once you get this turkey crotch pot. Comes with stove bottom stuffing and a temperature probe.
I was sitting in the movie with my baby love when all of a sudden my undies started smoking, basting juices started running down my leg, and a drumstick popped up out of my right pocket. She turned to me and said, "I love you too."
To what are this, pot in the pants? All you do is send your name, address, and give us thanks in the amount of $55. Send it to Turkey Trot, Post Office Box 5555, Pilgrim, Tennessee. We claim no responsibility for any leftovers in your pants.
Joining us live now via satellite at 710, that little man. Good morning, little man. How you doing this morning?
Morning, Ian. I'm in the Senate Judiciary Committee room right now. I am acting as a senator.
You're acting as a senator?
Senator Jim Sasser came down with a bad voice.
Oh, I see.
So I'm taking over for him. I'm chairing the committee. I'm going to be asking Judge Thomas, Clarence Thomas, some questions about this sex business.
About this sex business, about the sex harassment, and about the, supposedly the X-rated tapes.
I got to get this thing going.
All right, little man, go ahead. Chairing the committee.
The hearing will please come to order. I'm Senator Little Man of the great state of Tennessee. Judge Thomas, let me welcome you into the committee room here. I know you're here to clear your name. If I may start the line of questioning. Speaking of names, what name does your wife call you in bed?
I am Bigfoot.
Now, no one else heard you talking dirty to Anita Hill. Is that correct?
They were whispers.
Oh, you were whispering. Well, after you became a judge, you never did ask Miss Anita Hill to spank you, did you?
I think it would undermine my ability to sit.
Now live via satellite from out at the Hermitage is that little man. Good morning, little man.
Oh.
Little man.
Naomi.
Little man. What is that sound, little man?
First big day of fanfare. Fanfare that week when Garth Brooks learns that, yes, he really does have friends in low places. Testing. Ian.
Good morning, little man. How are you?
Hi, Ian. How you doing?
Good. Thank you very much for coming by this morning, little man.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, it's my pleasure.
No. You know, these kiss and tell books are getting hot.
I know, like the Geraldo book, Exposing Myself.
Geraldo, and then Joan Rivers got one out, and that shocking Ralph Emery book.
Oh, I know. You know, it is shocking. Ralph Emery tried to kill a guy. It's just a little hard to imagine.
Because of his love for Skeeter Davis.
Which is even harder to imagine.
I think it's interesting, right after they got married, Skeeter Davis put out a song called The End of the World.
That's true.
However, there is a book that people are overlooking that Little Man's going to read an excerpt from this morning.
Little Man is going to read an excerpt from a kiss and tell book that we're overlooking?
Yeah, I've got an advanced copy of the latest shocking expose book by another local television personality.
And that is?
Snowbird.
Snowbird?
Yep.
A kiss and tell book from Snowbird.
A book entitled Sex, Drugs, and School Closings. Snowbird has told Myron the Rat. revealing stuff about Snowbird. By the way, he was not born in the Arctic cold.
He was not born in the Arctic cold.
He's really from Yonkers. His name is Sidney Kamensky. His father owned a Glosher shop, sold Glosher's door-to-door. Then became one of the rubber barons. I'm going to read now from Chapter 4.
Chapter 4 of the Snowbird Kiss and Tell book.
Entitled, Wind Chills Up My Spine. This is Snowbird speaking. I would meet her at the Daystop Motel on Whitebridge Road. Her car screeching to a halt in front of the room. She was out of breath, having just finished the midday news. We wasted no time. Sharon would practically have her blouse off before she got out of her truck. As she entered the room, I would make that little joke that rhymed with her name, fuck it. She would brush up against me, careful not to let me touch her hair. She was so protective of the hair and yet so unprotective of the rest of her body. Her hand slid down there and she smiled and said, oh, Snow, honey, why don't you make it stand up for education? I pushed her down in the bed, careful not to touch her hair. But her hands behind her head straddled her and shouted, this one's for the family. Then the phone rang. It was Bill.
Bill?
Giving me the heat index and asking me to lay the phone down next to our bed. It was a ritual. He liked to listen while playing with raw pork.
Oh, God.
Unknown to me, in the motel room next door with his ear pressed against the wall, listening to the squeaking bed springs, Sharon moaning and me yelling, no school, no school, was the Channel 2 can man.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Tomorrow I'll be reading from the chapter 12. Dan McDaniel on the hockey team.
Oh, no.
Snowbird's expose, it's hot. It's in all the stores.
No school. Yeah. All right, thank you very much, little man. At 7:14, looking forward to another installment tomorrow morning on 103 KDF from Sex, Drugs, and School Closings.
You know, today is the birthday of our KDF general manager and vice president. Not just general manager, but vice president. Just like Dan Quayle.
Yeah.
Vice President Steve Dickert.
That's right, Steve Dickert, happy birthday. 39 years old today, Steve Dickert.
Yep. Mm-hmm. I would have gotten him a present, but I'm having to save my money for that big depression he's been predicting.
That's right.
Been predicting that for years. Some big depression coming.
Yeah. Well, he pockets the cash.
I'm having to supplement my income now.
Oh, yeah? What are you having to do to supplement your income?
I'm wearing a blonde wig and working mornings as Mary Glenn Lassiter. Yeah, we're the actual same height.
Are you really?
Yeah, in order to reach the microphones, we're sitting, we have to wear elevator butts.
Anyway, 7:14, and what do you got for us?
Little tribute, what Steve Dickert means to the little man.
What Steve Dickert means to the little man.
Steve Dickert, D. D is for the dough, you hoard. I is for I can't pay you that. C is for can't pay you that. K is for can't pay you that. H.
H
is for the hair. For Hair, the musical he never saw.
Yeah.
E.
E.
It's for E can't pay you that. A. Can't spell it.
No, you can't.
But you know what I'm trying.
Not Dickert. Let's see what we're spelling here. D-I-C-K-H-E-A. I don't think you're spelling Dickert there.
Oh, here's the rest of it. A, ask me for a R, raise. And I'll T, tell you I can't pay you that. Dickhart. Dickhart. Steve Dickhart. Happy birthday.